When you start Final Cut Pro 10 for the first time, it will look like this. You'll notice there is one empty event that has already been created for you. To rename an event, click on it and press the return key. In this example, I'll rename the event to Jamaica Promo. Okay, an event is how Final Cut Pro keeps media organized. Since Final Cut Pro already created this event for you, it will be located on your system drive inside your user folder and then inside the movies folder. Since the first event is empty, you will see the option to import media. When I talk about importing media, this can be from existing movie files, or it can be from a camera. In the upper left corner, Final Cut Pro will list the available cameras and devices where you can import media. Okay, to import files into an event, select the appropriate device. In this case, I'll be importing existing movie files from a thumb drive. You can see that my media is already organized, and Final Cut Pro will allow you to preview the files before importing them. What's really nice is that you do not need to import individual movie files one at a time. You can select an entire folder of movie files, and those folders can also have subfolders. Then, in the lower right corner, click the Import Selected button. Now, a dialog box will appear with several options for importing your media. By leaving all these options unchecked, Final Cut Pro is going to simply reference the media from where it currently lives. Don't worry, I'll come back and explain the rest of the import options in a later lesson. Okay, so if I press the import button, I now have instant access to all my clips within an event.